Hi, my name is Mbali Lamini.
Hi, my name is Pumlani Nduli.
We are Preem Group, a multidisciplinary collective based in Johannesburg, South Africa.
The collective is a collective of artists, digital curators, working within the intersection of performance, film, and research.
The exhibition we are curating for the Fagukesi Festival is called Spatial Fabrications. The work speaks to notions of space, utopia, and questions if a utopia is unimaginable.
This is a project that uses web VR. We're interested in the idea of web virtual reality as it is encompasses different performative gestures for the users, and it allows certain joins, disconnections, and it weaves all various nodes of images together.
Well, we question if there is a digital African culture. And pre-end, our practice is to use this platform to speak about and problematize the questions around an African digital culture.
The question of African digital culture is important within the context of the work that we're working on for the exhibition, because we are also interested in the idea of open source technologies and how open are open source technologies when they're placed within the lens of decoloniality.
I think this is what we've been trying to speak about with our practice also. We are questioning this existence of an African digital culture, because most of the platforms that we use or the technologies that we use, we didn't create. So how do we then start to define what an African digital culture is when we haven't actually created these places that host our content and also that we use to publish our content or even create it? So I guess what Pre-End aims to do with some of the workshops that we do and using some of these equipments and seeing how we can hack them and like alter them or change them is trying then to see how we can decolonize these material, these equipments, and make them our own, therefore creating an African digital culture.
Hi, my name is Kensani Mkari. I'm from Johannesburg, South Africa. I'm a multidisciplinary artist and art curator cultivating the fields of cultural production. The exhibition I'm curating for the Fawuzi Festival is Tamasab, which is a Xitsonga word that stands for Mother Earth. What I aim to do with this exhibition and the work select is to refigure the internet space as a space for healing and not for extraction. So instead of using like a normal website with like normal 3D galleries and all of that, I'm trying to stray away from that and reconfigure that space and sort of ground it in African cosmology by using the cosmogram as an interface. So the section of the cosmogram, you click on them, sort of show you there's an artwork behind every part of the cosmogram that correlates to what that part of the cosmogram means. So creating a new interface that's really informed by our indigenous symbolism and our culture and our history, you know? So how the artists do this and the works select to do this is through the use of surveillance tools, but refiguring them into tools for healing and civil agency. The artists I'll be working with are Double K, a duo which produces sound geared towards healing and spirituality. I'm also going to be working with Makolide and Natalie Pening and a couple of other artists exploring these themes. This work is important for African digital culture because it draws from the culture and sort of reasserts the importance of our lineage and our history. That's the big idea.
Hi, my name is Elizabeth Ifwa Sutherland, and I live in Accra, Ghana. I am a curator of digital stories and digital storytelling. I am also an artist. I have a background in performance, which is theater and dance specific, but then grew into kind of new media, so exploring things like projection, augmented reality, and different other forms as, you know, the story demands for it. So I'm quite narrative in my approach to my work. And I also spend a lot of time in education. So I teach from really early years all the way up to university level. So the exhibition I will be curating for the 2020 Fagukesi Festival is a digital storytelling exhibition, and it's titled Time, the Earth, and Death, Our Living Things as Stories Are. and that's from the introduction to an Alice Kane book. And Alice Kane was a storyteller who really believed that stories can mend broken people and broken worlds. And I'm really interested in exploring those specific themes around now, what's specifically happening in the world now, not just related to the pandemic, but related to, you know, all these broken systems that the pandemic exposed and all the highlights of this year, you know, this the kind of multi-hyphenate issues that have emerged over the course of 2020. And so I will be working with four griots from different parts of the continent, and they will be curating subsets of stories around these themes. It's a co-created digital storytelling exhibition that will be hosted as a web app, and that will be accessible by phone and on desktop. And basically, we are crowdsourcing story submissions that will be kind of sub-curated by all these griots who come from different cardinal points of the continent, so from the north, the south, the east, and the west. And they will be responding to this idea of stories are something that can mend broken people and broken worlds. And the idea is to kind of make them into this clickable interactive map so that people can not only browse geographically, but also use things like hashtags to link the different content of the different stories and brush up to other people in other parts of the world in ways that they might not have expected. This project is important because African history is oral history, and a lot of our history has been kind of negated or ignored because it hasn't been written down. And what the digital allows you to do is actually, for the first time in a very long time in history, to present that as valid on a global stage, because it makes those thematically held narratives accessible across the world using the internet, and kind of demonstrates the rich, broad connections that we have to each other. And I think always by really diving deep into hyperlocality, so where people are from and the lore around where they're from and the memories that they have from where they're from, we actually start to draw broad connections across tribe, across nation, across race, across humanity. So that's really important.
Hi. My name is Faye Kamerikagwa. I live in Cape Town, South Africa. I'm an aspiring curator, an arts administrator, writer, and producer of experimental artistic collaborative events. So I come from a theater background. I work as an arts administrator in theater for children and young audiences, but I've also managed to write. I'm an arts and culture writer, have been published by New Frame and Mail and Guardian and other publications. And in my spare time, I dream up events that kind of blur the lines between artists and audiences. And I'm really excited about the possibilities that happen within that space. The exhibition I am curating for the Fakugezi Festival is called Dear Us Matric 2020. It speaks to the lives of South African teenagers, specifically matric students, and what it's like living through a global pandemic in their final year of schooling. So this exhibition utilizes WhatsApp as an exhibition platform, specifically the WhatsApp status. It also uses WhatsApp for activation purposes. So we're really looking at creating meaningful interactions through the WhatsApp platform. And we're using this because this is where our audience is. This work is important to African digital culture because it prioritizes engagement and access. It's an exhibition that responds and reflects, reacts to its audience in a way that is familiar to them. When we think about the digital space, we think of equipment or technology or projects that a lot of Africans can't afford or can't access. And then we look at something as low-tech as WhatsApp and don't see the digital potential. The very fact that it is an app means that it is digital. It is something that people are using daily. It is the most downloaded app in this country. It is one of the most popular apps on this continent. And so I'm really interested in finding ways to engage with people, because that is where our audience is. As much as we can imagine these virtual worlds and we can have AR technology, and as much as I think that people should be doing that, I think that there's a real potential to exclude people, a real potential to see low tech as not digital and therefore not innovative. And so what I really want to do is push the art world to embrace the low tech and see what amazing, innovative, imaginative things we could potentially do on this application. Yeah.
Hi, my name is Zopa Wallace. I live in Durban, South Africa. I am a creator, visual artist, and an AR designer. I create face filters for social media and also augmented experiences based on social media. The exhibition I am creating for the Fagugesi Festival is called Afridelic, Trip a Digital World. Afridelic presents themes influenced by African mysticism using augmented reality showrooms and face filters as tools of interaction between humanity and the cosmic realms. So the project will be heavily led and influenced by anonymous artist Juan Mash, who's based in Johannesburg. So what I like about his style is that it mixes African aesthetics into a very westernized vaporwave culture. So he managed to pick up themes and base them on African mysticism and spirituality. And a lot of digital content is very westernized and stuff, so, and Western influenced. So it's quite nice to have a different approach in keeping things very African and also adding culture into it. This work is important for digital African culture because my peers won't even understand if I discuss it, you know, like it's just something that's quite foreign to a lot of people, the people that I'm surrounded with. So a lot of times people confuse my work with being an IT specialist, and I'm not an IT specialist, you know. I just had a drive for finding new ways to create outside taking a photo or painting and all that stuff. So the aim for me is to be able to show people that it can be done. I am from South Africa. I mean, it's in social media. It's very saturated with international content, you know? So a lot of people, even people younger than me, look up to that work. So I'm trying to move those eyes into more home, look more into home before you look more upward. So it's something I haven't really solidified yet, but that's actually the aim. Since my collaboration with the Fagugesi, I'm starting to solidify that a bit more.